would you like to swing?
During your enlistment process, you were to go through a series of physical and mental health examinations. If you passed, your paperwork was stamped as 1A. If you failed, it would be stamped as 4F, preventing you from joining the armed forces. After passing this initial examination, it was important to maintain your health. This is why your hygiene was critical. On the battlefield, combatants weren't your only enemy. Such things as disease, trench foot, among other threats, were major causes of casualties. In order to prevent yourself from suffering from these ailments, it was important to keep up with your personal hygiene. Your hygiene could be maintained through regulations established by the U.S. military. There are many ways of taking care of yourself while in the field. Even today, this threat is still very much a reality, as it is still possible to acquire these afflictions. Today's video will be discussing the importance of personal hygiene and adhering to proper grooming standards while attending reenactments. The most important aspect of care comes in your hair, feet, teeth, and overall management of your body.
Grooming of your hair was strictly enforced by the military. Although not as strict as it is today, your hair was to be cut down to where it was not touching your ears or neck. It was very popular for soldiers to wear a medium to short tapered haircut. There were a vast array of hairstyles, some of the most common being a taper, a butch style, and white walls. While longer hairstyles can be found, rarely any feature the size of your head with anything notably long. While in barracks stateside, soldiers would have easy access to haircutting facilities on base. They could go to a local barber while on leave as well. Shaving was also an incredibly important aspect of your time in the military. In order to build discipline, as well as to create an effective seal to your gas mask, soldiers were expected to be constantly shaving, also being issued a shaving kit in order to further enforce the activity. While there is documentation of GIs having beards, these men were the exception and not the norm. This can cause for great demonstration for the public who comes to these reenactments. So you see, it's
all up to you. In addition to your hair, your feet were another part that required much attention. As a soldier, you are expected to do a lot of marching and running, and you have to ensure that your feet are in peak condition. After a long march or a long day in the field, cleaning one's feet was a major concern, as sweat and other elements could cause your feet to get wet. After getting them cleaned and dried with foot powder, it's always good to put on a fresh pair of socks. Make sure your socks are made for your size, as socks that are too big or too small can result in blisters. Reusing the same pair could also subject your feet to blisters, as well as those other moistures that you had just cleaned your feet to get rid of. Improper foot care can result in such health complications as athlete's foot, and in worst case scenarios, trench foot, so be sure to pack at least two pairs of socks for every day you'll be at the event. Ensuring your boots are properly broken in are huge as well, as stiff shoes can be a major cause for blisters and foot pain. To break in your boots, you can work the sole to make it flexible, or you can wear them around day to day outside of events to wear them in. Foot care was, and still is, essential to the GI's overall health and efficiency.
$20 for the...
Moving along with critical elements of daily hygiene, we have dental care. It was recommended by Army dentists to brush your teeth once in the morning and once at night. Soldiers while on base had access to on-site dentists for routine checkups and emergency dental problems. Soldiers were issued toothbrushes and tooth powder as part of their issued toiletry roll. The three main types of toothbrushes that were found would be made out of bone, wood, and the issued plastic style. Toothpaste could have been issued in small doses but was much more of a private purchase item, along with dental floss, which were available for purchase at local PX or postal exchange stores. While attending events, it is strongly encouraged to keep up with your normal oral hygiene routine, as you would at home to prevent any issues from arising while in the field. While performing vigorous exercise, our bodies will produce sweat. Sweat, when left on the skin, can cause irritation and discomfort. The overall management of your general hygiene while in the field will certainly affect how comfortable you are. We highly recommend you pack a bar of soap, a fresh face towel, and body powder to keep yourself clean and dry. Areas of the body that should be kept clean would include the face, neck, underarms, and feet. At some events, you might be fortunate enough to have access to field showers, in which case you should prepare accordingly with a body towel and shower shoes. When possible, it is also important to attempt to keep your hands clean and nails trimmed to avoid any discomfort from hangnails or other injuries. As silly as it sounds, even a day or two without washing can have a major effect on your overall health and morale. Staying hydrated at a reenactment is absolutely critical.
Prior to arriving at an event, you should confirm with event coordinators that there will be access to clean drinking water via a hose or by other means. You should be attending reenactments with a clean and usable canteen that can be filled with drinking water. Your canteen should remain filled at all times and within reach. You should be regularly taking sips from your canteen throughout the day. It is your company aidman's responsibility to remind you to keep hydrating. If you notice yourself becoming thirsty, you are already experiencing the beginning stages of dehydration. Many events take place during hot summer weekends, and wearing heavy wool clothing will cause you to sweat, dehydrating you even faster. Stay on top of it. Don't let yourself become a heat casualty. While marching in tall grass at events in the summer, it is not uncommon to come in contact with ticks. These little buggers can be very inconvenient and even dangerous. You should take care to thoroughly check yourself and your battle buddies while at events for ticks that might have latched onto you. Should you come across one, the best way to remove it would be with a pair of tweezers. In terms of buying this all for yourself, there are quite a number of websites that manufacture reproduction toiletries. Most notably are websites like World War II Soldier, which sell a large amount of reproduction toiletries to be used, though it is worth noting that their shipping is not always consistent, so proceed with caution. A great site to purchase your Army-issued toothbrush from is Ravenna Armory, which offers them in green and red colors respectively. For the question of storing your toiletries, there are a few ways of doing so. You can use a Red Cross ditty bag, which you can find on such websites as At the Front, World War II Soldier, among other sites, or you can find an original on eBay. Or there's the option of purchasing yourself a toiletry roll. Our recommendation are the rolls sold on Etsy by Sergeant Martin's Military Surplus. A link for them will be in the description. Keeping yourself looking clean and presentable is not only necessary to your impression, but to your own health. Making sure you bring the proper supplies will help ensure not only this, but will help you have an all-around more comfortable experience while reenacting. With that being said, we hope you enjoyed the video. Be sure to stay tuned for future episodes.
And remember,
you're in the Army now, you're not behind the plow. You'll never get rich while digging a ditch, you're in the Army now. You're in the Army now, you're in the Army now. You'll never get rich on the salary which you get in the Army now.